Hello there, everyone. This is the first vintage radio review on this channel. Today we are reviewing a 1958 Philips B2X80U, a small extra radio, so to speak, that people would have in their bedroom, used in their teen's bedroom, or in the kitchen. It is a nice looking radio set, made from Bakelite, with a polystyrene front. It's quite sturdy. And it has very modern looks for 1958. I absolutely love it. In this review series we will review the looks, the sound quality, the sensitivity and the selectivity. And of course the overall impression and an overall judgment on how much I like these things personally. Let's start with one of the most important things, the sound quality. For this we will set the tone control to neutral and we will tune in into Radio Caroline on 648 kHz, one of my favorite radio stations. Let's try another radio station, Radio Monique on 918. It has a tone control, just neutral and high cut. So the sound quality is pretty okay, but I do not think it's more than just okay. Especially on neutral, I think the sound is way too bright and aggressive. And this is caused by this pretty generously sized and very high efficiency AD2500 speaker. But that loudspeaker is also very aggressive. Let's try it on gramophone pickup, or actually Bluetooth. Neutral. Let's see if I don't accidentally have an equalizer set. No. Alright, so also on the gramophone input it is very aggressive. Let's see if with an equalizer we can adjust the sound a bit. Let's remove some 2 kHz and 4 kHz. A bit too much. Add some 125 Hz. Remove all everything below that. So let's move on to the reception qualities of this radio. It is about 4 o'clock in the afternoon in a town near Amsterdam, the Netherlands. Inside, in an environment with quite a lot of interference. And there is no external antenna connected. It is working on the internal ferrite antenna. The first thing we hear is Arab music. With the separate receiver we can pinpoint the right frequency, and this is actually Radio Iran transmitting on 558 kHz with a million watts. Already a very good catch for a domestic radio with an internal antenna.
I'm out of office this week on holiday.
Some Pink Floyd on Radio Caroline. Very good reception.
Moon is coming on as well.
Moon is coming on, yes.
All kinds of interference. The internal antenna is directionally sensitive. So you can turn the radio for the best reception and the least interference. This is daytime reception and it is really quite good. And opposed to what I was expecting of this radio, the amount of interference is considerable, but for an AC-DC set that has no power supply transformer, it doesn't really get a lot of interference from the mains. Less than I thought.
Het klinkt dus als één muziekzondag. Het staat in de second half.
Oh, I hate those buzzing sounds. It is very sensitive, even on the built-in ferrite antenna. So, how good is the reception on long wave?
4 points, two from open play and two from freeze over the course of a blistering.
Poland, Ireland, and England. And someone over here should be Romania too. Not great, not great. Not terrible, not great. Back to medium wave. How good is the selectivity? How good is it at separating a strong transmitter from a neighboring weaker transmitter? This is the strongest station on the band where I am. And it can just about separate it from a weak British station. Especially by turning the radio, you can get rid of Radio Monique. But the filters are quite wide. So, that was daytime reception. We will wait a couple of hours and try again after dark, because nighttime reception on medium wave is a lot better. And here we are for the evening test of the Philips B2X80U.
Beatles, Daxman ready, and after the record I have a question about that as well. The list...
It is celebrated right in front of the...
There is a lot to hear, even on just the internal antenna. Despite all the noise... And let's check long wave. This is 252 kHz. Let me check which transmitters. There are both at the same time. This is 252 kHz with both Algeria and Ireland audible at exactly the same time. And if you use the directional antenna, you can make one of the two transmitters disappear. Poland. UK Radio 4. And very quiet Romania, I think. Let's switch to medium wave and use the external antenna. We are now at the bottom end of the medium wave.
Vamos a resolver quién es para los que no lo sepan todavía.
Quitamos de dudas y sortearemos, digamos.
Claro.
In front of us right now are on pole.
Absolutely filled with transmitters, filled with stations. kHz. This is The Hague's Hindustani radio. And that was about it. So, extremely good reception with the external antenna. Can't say anything else about it. It's like a 9 out of 10. And I do have to say, the sound quality is definitely a bit better than of the little one over there. It has a bit more bass, although you do need to use the tone control to dampen the highs at high frequencies a bit. It's just too shrill, too shrieky to use without it. Anyway, hope you liked it. See you next time.